Amen. Thank you, John Mark. Wherever you're at, whether you're here at the warehouse or at home, I do invite you to please stand as we start our worship. And just reflect on the word that was given to us today, such a timely word. Here on earth, we have a choice to make. Amen. And I don't know about you, but I choose God. And as John Mark said, the gospel may bring division, it may bring issues, it may bring conflict, it may bring disagreements. You may lose people in your life. People may walk away from you because of that. But even above all that, I still choose God. Simply because he loves me when I fail him. He stands by my side when everyone leaves me. And simply because it's his breath in my lungs. Church, when you accepted the gospel, when you accepted the truth, when you accepted God, he breathed life into you. You have his breath in your lungs. And you make that commitment to use that breath to spread his word, to spread the light, the truth, the gospel. So today we're going to sing a song that is very familiar, Great Are You, Lord. But I challenge you to join me in making it personal. We're going to make it personal this morning. It's your breath in my lungs, so I pour out my praise, pour out my praise. It's your breath in my lungs, so I pour out my praise, I pour You're so great, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Wherever you're at, I want to ask you to just lift your hands and surrender. And every one of us is struggling with something, whether it's finances, whether it's COVID, whether it's a loss, whether it's our own anxiety or depression. This morning we're going to give it to God and we're going to submit to Him, because we know that in Him He has already won the victory. Amen.
She
Because we have the victory in you, Lord. No matter what may be going on in our lives, Lord God, no matter who opposes us, no matter the controversy, no matter the division, no matter the suffering, the persecution we may face, you are great and you have won the victory for us. Lord, we thank you just for what you have done in our lives already, Lord. We thank you for what you are doing right now in this church, in these ministries, in these families, Lord God. And we just thank you for what you will do for us, Lord. We thank you again, God, because you are just so great and so loving and so worthy of our praise. How could we not praise you? How could we not give you glory that you deserve, Lord? We thank you so much, Lord. And God, you deserve all the glory, and we know that you are a glorious God. Amen. Church, do you believe that God, the God we serve, is glorious? Amen. Amen. We're going to sing this song. It's called Glorious. But go ahead and clap your hands with me. Sorry.
Glorious. Shout it out and glorious. Make it loud and Jesus, we shout your name.
Loud and Jesus, we shout your name, Jesus.
glorious. Shout it out and glorious. Make it loud and Jesus, we shout your name. Jesus, we make your praise glorious. You are glorious.
Thank you, God. Thank you. I'd like to pass it to Nathaniel.
Amen, church. All of you guys are definitely blessed by this worship. Give us an amen in the chat, in the live stream or not, but amen. We already feel your presence, Lord God, in our houses, Lord God, and in this warehouse, Lord God, and we just want Jesus to give you back the praise and honor and glory you deserve. So as we pray, church, just put yourself in a reminder that it's going to be difficult. The path ahead has many obstacles, but this path, it's not a sprint, but it is a marathon. You aren't rushing to the finish, but you are taking your time to develop your relationship with God, to be able to develop your own skills, develop your talents, so that you can serve God in your fullest. So let us bow down our heads as we go into prayer. Lord Heavenly Father, we come before you, Lord God, and we just want to just love on you. Heavenly Father, Lord, you have given us such a priceless gift, Lord God. You have given us something that we can't even give back in return, and that is the sacrifice that you have made by giving your Son, Jesus Christ, to die on this cross for our sins. Heavenly Father, Lord, we know that this price is something we can't ever repay. But Lord God, all you're seeking from us is our obedience, Lord God, to be humble before you and follow your ministry, follow your mission. So Heavenly Father, Lord, we lay down all of these negative things that we have, the pride, Lord God, this aggression we may have. We lay it all down before you so that we can be children of God and be sent out into the world to do your bidding. So Heavenly Father, Lord, may we just remember, Lord God, that you are omnipotent, you are almighty, and that even though we may have obstacles in our path, we may have conflicts, we might even have struggles with our own family members, we know that you are the center of everything, and that we can rely on you if any problems or challenges may happen, because we know that you are God. So Heavenly Father, Lord, as we come to an end to our service, we also uplift this special prayer request just for general healing, Lord God. Heavenly Father, Lord, we know that this COVID has been going throughout the months, Lord God, but Lord, we already know that you are already making progress, already healing happening, Lord God, and so we proclaim it right now, healing, Lord God. Heavenly Father, we know our healing is already taking place and that you are the upfront force foremost, Lord God, in all of this. So we trust you, God, and we already know it's already happening. So, Lord God, as we come before you and ending the service, we just want to love on you, Lord God. Thank you for all the blessings and all the gifts you've given us, and all we want to do is give it back to you. So we want to just thank you, God. We want to thank you, Jesus, and thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, everybody says, amen. Bye, guys.